Hey everybody, it's Brandon Lovell. Hope you guys are all having fun at Leslee's bridal shower.
Adam and I met at Applebee's. He came in to eat, and his roommate and I worked together at Applebee's. And he asked about me.
How did we meet? We met at Applebee's. My roommate was good friends with her when she worked at Applebee's, and I pointed her out and I said, "Hey Jordan, she's cute," and then he had her come over and start talking to me.
Our first date, it wasn't like a typical date, I guess. He had been asking me out for a while, and I was always working at Applebee's, so I could never go. But one time I got off work a little bit early. I got off at like 10 o'clock or 11 o'clock, and he had game night, and he was playing Murder in the Dark. And he shut off all the lights in the house and the windows, and there's like 40 people there or something. There's probably 25 people there. And you go around the whole house, and there's one person that's a murderer, and they pinch someone. And when they pinch someone, that person screams, they turn off the lights, or turn on the lights, and you have to guess who the murderer is before everyone dies. So he invited me to go to that. And later, I found out that he was kind of dating another girl, and she was invited too. And he invited me, thinking that I wouldn't actually be able to go, because I never could go before, because I was always working. And so I ended up going, and it was fine, but he wasn't as friendly as he normally is. He was normally more friendly. And then later I found out it was because he was kind of towards the tail end of dating this other girl. First date was August 22nd.
First date. First date took a long time to get to, but I think our first time was I invited her over to play games one night, and she got all awkward because she thought me and a good friend of mine had something going on, but she was a little awkward about it, but it worked out. What day it was like August, I want to say August 21st is like when we usually celebrate that, so we'll say August 21st.
Our first kiss, I think, was like a week after our first date. We went over to my house, my apartment, we were watching me, and we kissed.
I think like the night after that.
Oh.
Probably, yeah. Yeah, August 22nd then.
When we first started dating, we were together every single day from August until December. And then in December, I went home for Christmas, he went for Christmas, and we didn't see each other for like 3 days. And so then when we both got back, he was acting super lovey-dovey and like really touchy, and that's not really how he is. He's like not like that at all. And so I was acting really weird, so I knew something was going on, and he kept complimenting me, which he compliments me, like, a little bit, but this was just, like, every 5 minutes, like, compliment after compliment after compliment. And then, finally, he gave this little speech beforehand, and said, "You know what, I'm not always gonna act like this, but that doesn't mean I'm ever gonna change the way I feel about you, and I love you."
I did. It was the day before New Year's of that year, so like December 30th, I did, and I said some like long speech right before it, just saying how like I had thought about saying it for a while, and I said it like the night before New Year's Eve. Yeah, she'd been trying to get me to say it for like a little while. She didn't want to say it first.
Our his favorite restaurant, I would say Red Robin. And my favorite restaurant, I don't really know. I go through restaurants. I don't really have a favorite. I just, depends on what I feel like. But I guess Texas Roadhouse. I don't know.
We're gonna have to go Red Robin. Gonna have to go Red Robin. Can get that one. She'll get that one. That's a better question. I don't know. That's what I'm thinking. I don't know. She always goes through like phases where like she'll really like one place and she'll really like another. Right now, I have no idea what she really likes.
Okay.
We'll say Cheesecake Factory though. Just to give an answer. Like okay. If I had to give one answer, that would be it.
Right now he's a financial advisor for Fidelity, and I think that his dream job would be, or what he eventually wants to do, is be a portfolio manager for a finance company. And so he would just oversee certain portfolios for a big company, I think.
I'll probably play in the NBA.
Vacations would be going to Vegas with a bunch of his guy friends to watch the NBA summer games for like a week.
Okay, no, it's the same one. We went to California, I don't remember, was our first year or our second year together, and we hung out and she visited like where I grew up, and we went to SeaWorld, and I can't remember what else we did on that trip, but that would probably be it.
I don't know. I want to say one of the X-Men. I don't know. I remember watching that one with him specifically. We used to go to FYE. Is that called FYE? One of the video game and video stores. And we used to buy movies all the time together. But I think it was X-Men.
First movie. I have no idea.
This is not like even zero. Shot in the park, huh?
We watch a lot of movies. Nope.
Children, I think that he wants one. He wants one. I want an even number. I want two. I used to want like six, and then it moved to four, and now it's two. We agreed on us having two kids, but I don't want one ever.
How many do I want to have? She will say, I think the best answer is probably one. One. At this point, she's a three. She's a three.
Shoes. I have a lot. But I could really see Brandon sitting there and like counting all the shoes. So what would he say? I think that, let's see. I want to say 16. He'll probably say 16. I think 16.
That's hard, because she has a bunch that she never wears. She just keeps them in boxes somewhere. I try to get her to throw them away, and she just, like, stashes through shoes. There's a pair of basketball shoes I've never seen her wear sitting on the floor right now. I'm going to go with 20.
Brandon's biggest pet peeve is dishes. Hates dishes being on both sides of the sink. When we very first started dating, I surprised him in the morning with McDonald's breakfast or something. And so I was like walking out to leave, and he was in the kitchen the very first time, and like the only time, that I've ever heard him cuss was at the dishes in the sink. He was so mad. And so I'd have to say dishes on both sides. If it's in one side, he gets annoyed. But both sides, he needs it. Biggest pet peeve. I think that my biggest pet peeve is when people interrupt me when I'm talking. I do it to other people, but for some reason people do it to me. I hate it.
My biggest pet peeve? That's a good one. Her leaving stuff in the middle of the floor. Like, in the middle of the floor. Like, she'll walk in the house, and I don't know how she does this, but I just see them on the floor. And right in front of the doorway, there'll be, like, a pair of socks, like, dead center in the middle of the floor in the middle of the doorway. So she must have, like, got in the house. First thing she did was take off her shoes and socks and leave them there and just walk off. Right now... I know what it is, but I got to pass on that one.
My favorite food, I would say, is a really good cheeseburger. He likes all different kinds, but a really good one.
What is my favorite food? There's two answers for that, and she could guess either one of them. I really like fish tacos, and I really like cheeseburgers. So if I have to say one, I'm going to say cheeseburgers, because we eat those a lot more often.
The first person he met was probably Marshall. They worked together. No, wait. Whitey. It was Whitey, because we lived together.
No, her brother, Michael. Of course, they live together.
Brandon was born in Encinita, California. Or at least that's where he grew up. I think that's how you say it. Something like that.
Pasadena, California.
Favorite attribute that there's a lot of them. His about me. I think that he probably likes the fact that I'm always trying to better myself. No matter what it is, I just always try to get better. And then mine about him, there's a lot, so I don't know which one that he would say. But more than anything else, like, my biggest about him is I really love and appreciate the fact that he is who he is because it's the right thing to do. He's honest, and he has all these great qualities not because someone told him to, not because his mom raised him the right way, not because of the commandments or anything like that, but just because it's right.
What is her favorite attribute about her? Probably that she's always trying to better herself. She might get one on that one, she might not, but that's probably it. She compliments me a lot. She's real vocal about that. So if I had to pick one, I think she really likes that, like, I think for myself and I do the right thing because, like, I know it's right and not because there's, like, some sort of consequence to it. She might say that, she might not, I don't know.
And he's lived in Utah ever since. So, Brandon has lived in Utah ever since, so 15 years. When he moved to Utah, he moved to Salt Lake City with his mom in the house that his mom grew up in.
So, I was 15, so that'd be 12 years. Yeah, 12 years, 2001. Moved to Salt Lake City.
Salt Lake City.
Should get that, though, probably.
Brandon has two half-siblings. Woody, or Woodrow is one name, and Latasha. They are... I honestly don't even think he knows how old they are. I want to say in their 40s. 42 or something. But honestly, he probably won't even know. He'll probably say 40s. 40-something. Or 40-something. That's probably what I'll say.
40... Wait, 17 years older than me. So 44 and 43.
Brian has two, Castle and Roman. David has three, Claire, Dawson, and Tiff. Any? David, Darcel has two, Sam and Lucas. Michael has one, Benjamin, and then another one on the way in November. And then Marshall has one. Madeline.
Oh my goodness. I need a pen and pencil for that. Okay. I know I'm forgetting somebody. I'm at 11 right now. 12.
Our go-to was dinner and a movie. We love movies. I think that he really does like mini golf and Nickelcade. He likes Nickelcade. We go play this football game there, and we have gotten a lot of tickets from that. It's pretty funny.
Our go-to is probably just dinner and movie. We do that pretty often with both movie people. My favorite? Probably, I don't even know if you call this a date, but I'm gonna say it anyways. Probably my birthday. The first year we were together, she had this thing where she did 24 hours of gifts for me, and we like went out and did stuff.
Fun.
And she got me a gift every hour for 24 hours. She came through at night and woke me up.
Yeah. Better say the puzzle, because I took a lot of time on that thing. It is about 28 pieces to a puzzle. It's like one of those puzzles, it's like a 30-piece puzzle, and the puzzle pieces are like this big. And then I cut a heart out in it and tried to use all the puzzle pieces, but I didn't use a couple. I put paper on each side, so of the puzzle. On one side of the puzzle, it says a quality that I love about it, like being supportive, that he loves me, stuff like that. And on the back side, I would write why I love that about him or what he did that showed me that he had that quality. And then on the box, I wrote, my heart fits together with all the things I love about you. And then throughout like a month, before his birthday or before Valentine's gave him one puzzle piece a day. And then he put the puzzle piece together.
That most thoughtful one was she gave me, she made me a puzzle from scratch. And, like, on every little puzzle piece, there's probably, like, 25 little puzzle pieces that she made. It's got, just, like, the little thing that she knows about me. Like, on one side, it says what it is, like, my eyes or whatever. And then on the other side of the puzzle piece, it says, just, like, why she likes that particular thing about me, whether it's physical or whether it's, you know, personality-based. So that was
cool.
That was definitely most thoughtful.
Amazing, and I can be a princess. And I love you all.